Goldman Sachs is grappling with one of its biggest scandals ever, 1MDB. The investment bank is due to report earnings on Wednesday as Malaysia demands billions in compensation related to the sovereign wealth fund. Earlier today, I spoke to Malaysia's finance minister about all things 1MDB. Take a listen.
They are going to declare their annual earnings, yeah. Next month.
Yeah.
We hope they make the necessary provisions for reparations to Malaysia. We feel that Goldman Sachs have to bear responsibility, especially for bond issuance.
You want responsibility, you want reparations. So in terms of payback, how much?
$7.5 billion. That's what we are seeking. Mm. I think that's a very reasonable amount because the $6.5 billion raised through the bond issuance, we don't know what happened to the money. The fees were paid for services that was not duly rendered, breach of fiduciary duty. And of course, finally, the fact that they brokered a deal which was 100 basis points higher than the market rate, that doesn't, you know, make sense. I think many people can do that without paying you $600 million.
How do you plan to prove that this was the action of an institution and not just a few rogue individuals?
The fact that the executive, the senior executive who has pleaded guilty, has full access to the former CEO. And I think the evidence will clearly show that Goldman Sachs was in the know. How can you disclaim responsibility when you collected such a huge amount of fees? And at the same time, you were, of course, broadcasting the fact that you were representing Malaysia. I don't think they can run away so easily.
Now, both your government and the U.S. government have charged Jho Low, the alleged 1MDB architect and mastermind for money laundering and other offenses. He is believed to be inside China, but exactly where? Where is Jho Low?
Well, we are still searching for him, but we'll get him.
Do you believe that he's on the coast of China? Is he in Guangzhou?
I think that information is still at the moment speculative.
Yeah. There must be full accountability. And again, the architect is this Malaysian citizen, Jho Low, a boy from Penang. You're from Penang. Do you ever think what happened to this boy from Penang that would allow him to allegedly plunder billions from his home country?
I think the critical question would be, why did the Prime Minister allow Jho Low, who just graduated from college, to run riot, to do as he pleased? Why did he place his trust on the nation's treasury completely in his hands to do as he likes?
So
and
why?
I think that is a critical question.
How do you answer that question?
That's why we want the answer in court.
And finally, your message to the people of Malaysia who were supposed to benefit from this massive development fund, but this money has been allegedly siphoned away to purchase private jets, properties, multi-million dollar paintings, parties, etc. What's your message to them?
That we will do whatever it takes to ensure that justice is done. And that Malaysia will try to get as much of our money back. And finally, we want Malaysia, Malaysians especially, that they can hold their heads up high again, that Malaysia is no longer a global kleptocracy. We are now a normal, boring democracy.
You want to be boring?
Yes. I want to be a normal, boring democracy where there are no financial scandals. No more 1MDB, no more Jho Low, and of course, no more former Prime Minister.
Sir, good luck with that. Take care.
Thank you. Thank you, Kristie.